In just a few days, millions of people across the nation will look up for a stunning and rare event. You probably know by now the solar eclipse that will streak across the U.S. on Monday, but just how rare is it and what does it mean to the people who study our solar system? NASA astrophysicist Dr. Kelly Cork joins us live tonight to answer some of those questions and much more. Doctor, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you so much for having me.
Okay, let's start with the basics. Take us back to science class. What causes a solar eclipse?
So the solar eclipse is caused by a dance and just the alignment of the moon. So it's the sun, the moon, and the Earth. So the moon is casting its shadow on the Earth. That's all that a total solar eclipse is.
Okay, so people are going crazy for it. It just sounds so basic, but people are taking vacations trying to catch a glimpse of this solar eclipse. Tell us about the path of totality for it.
Right. So I, too, was a skeptic originally, even studying it. But then once you see it, you know that it's worth it. It's worth the travel to that path of totality. The path starts off the coast of Mexico, goes up through Texas, through 14 states, and then out through Maine and out through Canada. So it's a long path across the United States.
Okay, so we know that we're not in the path here really in Florida, but we will see a partial eclipse, right?
Right. In Florida, in Orlando, you'll see about a 57% eclipse. So that means you're always going to need your solar viewing glasses. And these are not sunglasses. These are much darker so that you're still at 57 or 58%. The sun's still really bright. So we want to make sure to protect our eyes or use an indirect method if you don't have those glasses, which could be making a pinhole projector where there's directions online or even using your fingers. You could just kind of make holes like here and you can see light coming through and project it onto the ground below you to see this partial eclipse.
Okay, so talk about that. Why do we need these glasses to protect our eyes? Why can't we look directly at it?
Well, the sun is very, very bright, and it can burn the back of your retina where the information goes into your eye, the normal light comes in, because it's so intense. So that's why we use glasses or an indirect method in order to look at the partial eclipse.
And we're not going to see another eclipse like this for years. Why is this so rare?
Right. So actually, there's an eclipse somewhere on Earth every around 18 months. But the Earth is a big place. There's a lot of places with water that we don't live. But in any individual place, it's around 300 years between the times that you actually get these eclipses. So the places that experience it right now, experience totality right now, probably won't experience totality for another 300 years. So it's a once in a lifetime event.
Wow, 300 years. Okay. And finally, talk about the research that will be conducted during this eclipse. And what do scientists hope to really get out of it?
So we're focusing on two types of science, the science that looks at the sun itself, and then the science that looks at the atmosphere or the reaction to the eclipse. We're flying a couple of planes, two WB-57s, to chase the shadow and get 2 extra minutes of totality to look at the sun's hot corona or outer atmosphere. And that's what you see in totality. The moon blocks the solar disk, and you'll see this hot, wispy, beautiful, structured atmosphere. And we're going to study that because we still don't understand how that affects our space weather. It's the effect on our satellites. It affects our electronics grid. It affects GPS. So we really want to understand this. So we're going to do that. And we're also going to study the Earth and our communications layer or the ionosphere with some rockets. We're going to shoot off 3 rockets and study it that way. So there's lots to learn in this eclipse.
That is fascinating. I hope you have a wonderful time studying this eclipse because we know it's going to be a while before we get another one. Thank you so much, Dr. Kelly Cork, for joining us tonight.